Things to know before you begin your plumbing career. When I started plumbing, I literally just got a job. I got a job as a plumber, and that's what I thought. I'm going to be a plumber. As I was in the trade so much longer and for so many years, I learned there's so many different types of plumbers that you can become. So things that you want to do before you begin your plumbing apprenticeship. You want to learn what kind of plumber you want to be. I talk to people all the time about that and let them know about the different options. There's residential, there's commercial, there's new construction, there's service, there's union, there's non-union, there's industrial. There's a lot of different things, and you have to know what kind of plumber you want to be. Now, you may not need to know all that right now, but to think about certain things to figure out what kind of plumber you want to be and things you may want to learn before you get into plumbing that can help you get ahead quicker. So anybody getting into plumbing needs to look at and think about what the job opportunities are. Now, in your area, they may be different than they are in mine. In your area, residential service may be the biggest thing on earth. In my area, new construction may be. Commercial construction may be. Maybe it's building new houses. What's going on in your area that can help you get a job, help you learn plumbing, and help you get ahead? So what I want to talk about are a few of those things today. First of all, what kind of plumber do you want to be? Do you know if you want to work on commercial or residential? Do you know if you want to do service or new construction? Look at the different opportunities. Look at the different companies in your area that may be hiring or may be doing a ton of work that could give you a good opportunity. Going through and learning about the different types of plumbing might help make your mind a lot easier. Some people prefer building things. And if they prefer building things, new construction is normally great for them. Whether it's residential or commercial really wouldn't matter. But if they prefer building things compared to fixing things is great for somebody, maybe for service. The reason being is we go to a building that's already built and we look at the problems. We analyze what's going on, what are the problems, and what can we do to find out what we can do to make it better. Building things, and don't get me wrong, I used to love building new buildings. I probably still do. But I also love the analytical side of trying to figure out what the problems are. Now, getting into the trades is great for you. Compared to going to college, oh my God, it's magic. Here's why. If you go to college, chances are you're going to incur debt to go to school. If you get into the trades, you're going to get paid from the very beginning. Did you get that? The day you get hired, the day you go to work, chances are you're going to get paid. Now, I say that because a lot of plumbing is on-the-job training. So what I would do is figure out what kind of plumber you want to be first, what kind of company is around you that may be hiring, and go in and apply for that job. But do research and figure out what do you want to be in the long run. Do you want to own your own company? Do you want to be a superintendent on big construction jobs? Or do you just want to run a plumbing truck and make customers happy? There's a lot of different opportunity there, and only you know what's going to make you happy. And we're all different. So what makes me happy may not make you happy. That's why I always tell people, look, think about what you want. And when you go in an interview, remember, ask them questions too. Are they going to be able to give you the knowledge that you need to become the plumber you want to be? And maybe not in the very beginning. Maybe in the beginning, you go get a construction job so you learn how plumbing is installed. Whether it's service, construction, or whatever, once you become a plumber and you know how it's installed, getting into service is a lot easier because now you know how it's built. And that will help you so much. So plumbing 101, you can learn that a lot of different ways. There's great YouTube people teaching you plumbing every day. Now, there are also books. There's also organizations. I've talked about the United Association. I've talked about PHCC. I've talked about the IPC and the UPC. Guys, studying is one way to help separate you from every other person that's becoming a plumber. If you're in a class with a bunch of other apprentices, look around. This is going to be your competition while you're going through the union or the PHCC trade school or whatever it is. What are you going to do to separate yourself from everybody else? I had somebody reach out just the other day and say, Roger, look, what can I do to get better? What can I do to grow more than these other people? Come on, guys, study plumbing. Get up in the mornings, study, get on YouTube, get on online sources to where you can read magazines or whatever. What kind of new tips, tricks, techniques, tools, what is out there that you can learn that'll set you apart and help you get better? Because to me, that's going to be your best deal. Getting out there and learning how you can do things different, how you can do things better, and learn the plumbing trade itself. If you're working with a plumber and you're trying to learn, look at what he's going to need next. What do you have? What knowledge do you have that can help separate you from what he's doing? And I ask that because one of the best apprentices I ever worked with, if I was up on top of a ladder working, hooking up a fan coil unit or putting in a drain line, whatever it is, by the time I turned to look down and say, hey, this is what I need, he was already standing there with it in his hand. And if it was copper fittings, they were already clean. If it was cast iron fittings, they already had Band-Aids with them. He was thinking where I was heading next and trying to get ahead of me. We were a great team because he made me look good, and I gave him all the credit in the world. I would always tell people, this kid is fantastic. He's now a superintendent in the union running work. That's a good thing because he's good at it. When it comes to moving ahead, you want to always look ahead. Where are you going to be next, and what is needed from you? Do you have the tools? Do you have the equipment? Do you have the materials that you need to do what you're going to be working on next? And if not, you need to start looking ahead, because when you're done with the project you're on, you need your next one lined up, ready to go to keep moving. The biggest tip, if you want to be the best plumbing apprentice you can be, learn to study. Get the code. Get the UPC study guide. Get the IPC study guide. Learn to study. Getting in these books and learning the code, knowing it, will help it click a little bit faster. And the more value you bring to the plumbing company that you work for, the more money you're worth and the more you're going to make in the long run. Guys, this is a great profession to get in. I highly recommend studying from the very beginning. That way you know what you're getting into. You know what you need to learn. And you're going to know what you can do to move ahead. I hope you've enjoyed this. If you're a plumber already, or you're already in the trades as an apprentice, put a comment down there. Let me know, what did you study? What did you learn that helped it click with you? Because with me, I literally remember the day I was driving down the road, pulling up to the job site, and all of a sudden it clicked. All of a sudden I was like, I know why we do what we do. And it's funny because it literally happened that way. When I got to the job site and went to the superintendent and said, hey, look, can I rough in that next building? And it was a top out, so it's a wall rough. But when I asked him if I could do it, he looked at me and said, do you think you're ready? I said, yes, I am. Guys, I'm continuously learning because I love this trade. Do me a favor. Leave me a comment down below and let me know what you're doing. If you like this video, do me a favor. Check out some of the other ones we got, or share this video with somebody you think might be wanting to get into the trades and could possibly learn something from it. Anyway, I hope you've enjoyed it. I'm Roger Wakefield, Lead AP, the Expert Plumber. I'll see you in the next video if you don't get flushed.